therapies, if we're moving towards a curative approach, whatever therapies we're using, whether it be chemotherapy, targeted treatments, antibodies, or even CAR T cells or transplant, then MRD is going to be an important endpoint for those therapies.
The technologies have continued to improve, and now we have flow cytometry assays. The best ones can detect about one cell in 100,000.
In all the other cases, which is probably half or more of the other cases, we're relying on flow cytometry currently.
So when it comes to PCR or NGS-based MRD detection, the pro is high sensitivity.
And of course, the future is going to be as we develop more and more of these targeted precision type of medications based that on this next generation sequencing.
In the future, we will get to a point where we all say this is the easier or better method to use, but developing multiple methods is always good.
MRD testing is the way of the future because it does allow you to optimize the management of an individual patient, and it can be an endpoint in a clinical trial.
What are the next pieces that we are missing? Well, I do think that we need to have these assays readily available, and that's coming. In the United States, I think within 2 months or so, the FDA is anticipated to approve next generation sequencing-based assay for MRD testing in the hematologic space.
MRD testing is going to be a part of high quality trials going forward. So I'd say if you're designing a clinical trial for AML and it doesn't include MRD as part of the response assessment, you're doing the trial wrong.
And we are still learning. And the best way to learn is in the clinical trials. But we still need more and more data in the clinical trials, learn from that data, and then try to apply the best in our ability in routine practice.
We're beginning to have studies that are focused around achieving MRD and utilizing MRD for treatment. And I think that's something we need to look forward to for the next year.